All right, so for this year, we've been planning for another camping trip. And for that, I did order a new electric fridge from Dometic. This is the CFX3 55IM model, which has the ice maker. In order to power this at the campsite, I bought an Aimtom SPS 500. I've been testing it yesterday because my fridge arrived. Battery arrived last week, I think. Yeah, but I didn't have much to test it other than able to power on, but not really testing about how the power draw. But one interesting thing is I found out that the battery itself on the 12 volts output, you can see currently is at 100% charge. I'm still charging it. The output is only showing 11.7, and that's what I was worried about. But yesterday when I plug in the Dometic fridge, and when it has power load, the voltage will actually goes up. It will power the Dometic fridge, no problem. But I mean, I've already set the battery protection. I already set it to low already, which means the cutoff power should be 10.1, I think the lowest, or 11.4. What I encountered yesterday was when the battery level drops to 78 or 76%, the voltage was actually dropping till 11.4 or 11.3 after I switch off the Dometic fridge and switch it back on. On the screen, it was showing voltage low. It has an alert about voltage low because it was below 11.4 or 11.3, something like that. So it's not able to power on. So this is what I'm gonna do again. I did make a video yesterday, so I'm gonna record this. I already contact Aimtom asking for a refund or return about this product because I look for the Jackery Explorer 500. A lot of reviewers saying that they have the 12 volts regulated. This doesn't seem regulated. I think in a way it is regulated, but in a weird way. It has lower voltage, so it won't be able to power on when the voltage is low. A battery at 78%, 76% should be good enough to power on the fridge, right? So that's what we're gonna test today. Let me hook up the fridge. Alright, I'm gonna unplug the charging cable here. Yeah, another bad thing about the Aimtom is even though when you see that it was 100% charge, as soon as you unplug the charging source, it may drop to 99% right away. And that's probably because it's not really, really fully charged. There's no way that I can tell whether it's fully charged or not. I think the percentage is not that accurate. And you can see now the voltage level drops to 11.6. Let's see like what happened if I turn on the fridge here, okay? And I also have the battery protection mode. See, so this is what I meant. So when it's in load, it actually increases the voltage. Remember, it was at 11.6. Battery inside actually has a 10.8 volt. They have to increase that voltage to accommodate any 12 volt appliance, right? Okay, so I'm gonna test out the ice maker thing too. At 96%, 12 volts. Let me plug in the AC power as well. Okay, so as soon as I plug in the AC power, it switch off to the AC automatically. And it's not withdrawing any power from the Aimtom. So you see the voltage drop back to 11.6. So in order to test it, continue to test it, I have to unplug the AC for now. And then for some reason, I don't know why, but I'm hearing this like water boiling sound when the Dometic fridge is running. Not sure if it's audible from the camera microphone. But other than the compressor running sound, which most people can tell, there is another sound like bubbling or water boiling sound at the back. Anyways, so we're gonna return in a while, see how it goes. Oh, I'm gonna unplug the AC power so I can draw from the Aimtom battery. So now, see this draw there? Voltage draw is 55 watts, and now it raised to 11.9. By the way, this is the, how the apps looks like on the Dometic. The CFX3 app, it shows the voltage of the battery, it shows the current temperature, and it is set it all the way to minus 22. You can adjust the temperature up and down, either by sliding that or using plus or minus sign. So current time is 3:53. Alright, so after 2 hours later, we're gonna come back and check how's the battery level gonna look like and the voltage reading, and also our Dometic fridge gonna cool down. Currently is at 10 degrees Celsius. Alright, so we started around 3:50. Oh, that's 4:15 and now 5:11. So a little bit more than an hour till now. Current battery level is at 82%. Voltage reading here, output is 11.5. And let's see on this Dometic fridge, what is the reading? It's 11.4. So yeah, it's pretty accurate. Okay, so after another half an hour, percentage dropped till 78%. Reading with the load is 11.3. And on Dometic, it shows 11.2. And what happens if we're gonna power it off? Let's see if we power it off from here. Let it sit for a while. Okay, let me power it back again. Alright, so this is what happened. See, like currently the battery level shows at 80%. Reading of the output shows at 10.9 volts because without load, even though when a fully charged battery shows 11.7. Now, after withdrawing 20%, is only remaining for 10.9 volts. And on here, detected as 11.1 volt, it shows alert voltage low. That's what I meant. At 80% on the Aimtom SPS 500 Raptor, it's not able to power on fridge anymore. And that's a big problem, right? I don't know how can I use this. That's why I want the refund and go with the Jackery Explorer 500. But if they're gonna ask me paying the shipping cost for returning it, I don't think that will work. Like, I'm gonna spend another, I don't know how much, overall the cost will be higher. Well, I think they should honor their own product here, which isn't functioning as it should, right? 11 volts here and 11.1 showing voltage low, not able to run the fridge at 80% battery. That sucks. I think the only way to kick this back on is using AC power, which I have that prepared, and I'm gonna plug in there and you'll see the Dometic detected the AC power and it will start running again. And this will remain as a brick, useless here, unless I plug in the power to the AC. But the problem is, because of the inverter, I don't think that will be much efficient compared to the 12 volt output. I'm gonna let it run for a while and come back again. Okay, so I don't know what to do with this. My alarm set it to 5:50 for 2 hours check has triggered. We basically were able to reach to minus 11 or minus 12 degree on this. The reason this is currently minus 11 is because we got interrupted while testing it, the DC power on this Aimtom solar power generator. Yeah, and after giving it a rest for a couple of minutes, instead of 80%, it went back to 81%. I'm gonna see if I unplug the AC power, if it's gonna kick in with the DC. One DC power with the AC unplugged, fridge still figuring out what is going on. The compressor did not kick off right away, so there's no power draw. But the good sign so far is at 11 volts. This time, it did not show the low voltage alert. Right, 11.1. And I think the fan just turned on the fridge and it's starting with rain power. So let's see here. Not yet. I hear something running on the fridge, but probably just okay, so just kick it in. See the wattage, 1934, 38 watts, and see, it was at 11.1, 11 volts, and once this has load, it does increase the voltage, even though I'm able to kick off the power like this, but what happens if it's go even lower? I mean, this is only at 79%, already struggling powering on the Dometic fridge with the lower battery level that we have. It's gonna be more difficult to power on. If I'm gonna go camping, I don't have an AC power unless using this one, which will withdraw the battery even more. By that time, if it's gonna be go below 70%, I don't think the battery voltage will hold up high enough to power on the fridge. The battery level is at 70%. And the time is 7 o'clock. The 12 volt output is showing at 11.1 or 0.2. The Dometic is detected as 11.1. So let's assuming after powering off the vehicle, if we need to move this to a different location, I need to power it off or unplug the cable, and then I'm gonna plug it back in. And let's see here. All right, so this is what happens. Yeah, alert voltage low, and currently DC detected as 10.8, 10.9, and obviously this is only 10.7 here because it's not withdrawing any power. So yeah, what can we do with this? So at 72%, you're not able to power on your Dometic fridge with this Aimtom 500, SPS 500. And this is why it is so important to have a regulated 12 volts output.